Hello everybody, coming at you guys with a brand new research video on a topic that's been drawing some big attention now that it's becoming more and more accepted in today's society. CBD, cannabidiol, a substance found in the natural and to some, the wonderful plants known as cannabis. Now when you think of cannabis, you think of that high sensation or getting them good old munchies. However, CBD is not responsible for those, rather that's attributed to another potent cannabis substance known as THC. CBD acts a little bit more quietly, often engaging cannabinoid receptors, which are normally activated with THC, in a much more indirect manner. This difference leads to CBD having different effects, effects like reportedly mitigating seizures and offering sleep benefits for certain disease populations. But the focus of this video is on how recently CBD has been marketed pretty heavily for something much more exercise related. More specifically, exercise recovery and performance. You know what? Let's just get straight to it. Although some people, even maybe yourself, might believe that CBD has helped in some way with their workouts like improving soreness or lifting heavier, the studies show, well, nothing. Because in terms of CBD and exercise research, we really don't have any. The research that many media articles and CBD companies tout for CBD's recovery benefits aren't really on exercise recovery, but on inflammation. Also, these inflammation studies either use rat models or pertain to specific diseases like multiple sclerosis. Exercise recovery was never the focus. For exercise performance, the scientific connection, again, is not on performance per se, but on anxiety. And again, we don't see research exhibiting anxiety relief specifically to you being able to lift heavy or something. Instead, we see more rat studies and studies on specific settings like public speaking. But yes, generally reducing anxiety might help you perform better, we just don't have the research to show that. And frankly, that's really the only objective conclusion we have right now. CBD research is still in its very early infancy, much to do with its legality only recently being partially absolved. Maybe in the future, we will see more data suggesting CBD can help, but right now, we can't be tossing a bunch of claims around when we don't know much. Heck, we don't even know what a good dose of CBD is in the first place for exercise or anything else. And another problem is that over-the-counter CBD products are often improperly labeled. A 2017 study found that only about 30% of 84 tested consumer CBD products were accurately labeled, and worse yet, 20% of them had moderately high traces of THC, even though they're labeled to contain none. Again, CBD and exercise, still very understudied and still need a lot of work on the consumer end. We gotta give it time. Thank you to my lovely Patreon members for voting for this topic, and a special shout out to Deleon Sam for being a super cool patron for pledging 10 bucks. Even though I couldn't give you guys a clear-cut answer, I hope it at least drives home the importance of not rushing to conclusions so quickly. If you want to participate in polls and video suggestions yourselves, please come check out the PictureFit Patreon today. There are some other cool rewards too. If not, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please give it a CBD thumbs up and share it with your not rushing to conclusions without proper research friends. As always, thank you for watching and get your protein. There's even hemp protein if that's something you want to try. Goodbye.